How's it going, everyone? Today we'll be taking a look at the NUC11 performance kit by Intel. Specifically, I have with me the NUC11PAHi3 model, which is powered by Intel's 11th generation Core i3 Tiger Lake processor. We'll take a look at the specs of this NUC, do the usual unboxing, and put it all together to run some benchmarks. Let's get started. Starting with the packaging, we see that Intel's gone for the usual blue theme that is pretty much in line with the company's brand image. Now, I'm really excited to put this thing together. It's the first time I'm working with a NUC, so it's gonna be fun. Here's the specs of the NUC11PAHi3. Intel's equipped this particular model with the Core i3 1115 G4 mobile processor, which runs at a base frequency of 3 GHz and can turbo up to 4.1 GHz. Do note that this is a dual-core processor with hyper-threading and integrated Intel UHD graphics. It comes with two DDR4 SODIMM slots with support for 64GB of RAM and the DDR4 3200 standard. Storage-wise, Intel's included a single PCIe 4.0 X4 M.2 slot, as well as a single SATA 3 port for a 2.5-inch SSD or hard disk. Finally, for internet connectivity, the NUC11PAHi3 comes with 2.5Gb Ethernet, powered by Intel's I225V and Wi-Fi 6 connectivity, courtesy of Intel's AX201. And with that, let's have a look at the contents of the box. Here it is, the NUC11PAHi3 in the flesh. Some first impressions, it seems to be mostly plastic in construction and has a small footprint. We'll take a closer look at the units later in the video, so let's set it aside for now and check out what else Intel has included inside the box. Setting aside the cardboard divider, we see that Intel has included a pack of screws to be used with the VESA mount backplate included in the packaging, a quick start guide, a leaflet containing safety information, as well as a regulatory notice leaflet. Documentation aside, we see that a VESA mounting backplate is included as well, and this will allow you to install your Intel NUC behind your monitor. And this is rounded up by a power brick. Do note that not all SKUs of the NUC come with the power cord included, such as in this instance, so you may need to get a separate power cord with a male C5 connector. And to round off the contents of the box, we get a Core i3 case sticker. Onto the NUC itself, let's get the protective stickers removed. Now, the NUC11PAHi3 has a no-nonsense and functional appearance. We get a variety of I/O ports on two sides of the NUC and ventilation openings on the other two sides. In terms of I/O connectivity, we get a Thunderbolt 3 port, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A port, a 3.5mm speaker jack, as well as the power button. Onto the next side with the ventilation openings, we get a SD card reader, which is handy to have. This is followed by a power adapter connector, a mini display port 1.4 connector, a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port, two USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type A ports, another Thunderbolt 3 port, and a HDMI 2.0b port on the rear side of the NUC. For the fourth and final side of the NUC, we get a Kensington lock opening. With that, let's have a look at the insides of the NUC. As mentioned earlier, the NUC11PAHi3 comes with a single PCIe 4.0x4M2 slot, and it is located right here. You'll note too that the Intel AX201 Wi-Fi module is in the same region, and is soldered directly onto the board. Over on the other end are the two DDR4 SODIMM slots that can support up to 64GB of RAM and the DDR4 3200 standard. The base plate of the NUC also doubles up as the mount with which to install a 2.5-inch SATA SSD or hard drive, and Intel has also included a thermal pad that comes into contact with the M.2 drive, that is, if there is a M.2 drive installed. And I guess this helps to dissipate heat from the said M.2 drive once the base plate is reattached to the chassis of the NUC. Pretty neat. To get this NUC up and running, I'll be installing a single 8GB stick of Crucial DDR4 3200 RAM. Following that, I'll be installing a Crucial P2 500GB NVMe SSD, and I'll be getting Windows 10 Pro installed on it. And with that, time to reattach the base plate to get a finished product that is ready for a Windows installation. As mentioned earlier on in the video, the NUC can be mounted on the back of your monitor if you so wish, provided that your monitor has VESA mounts on the rear. If it does, setting up the included VESA mounting backplate is a breeze and will allow you to save space on your desk. To get the NUC ready for mounting on the rear of your monitor, you'll need to install these two screws that come included with the packaging. With the VESA backplate installed on the monitor and the screws in place on the NUC, it's a simple matter of sliding the NUC into place. And with that, the NUC11PAHi3 is all ready for Windows to be installed. These are the final specs that I'll be running with for this particular NUC11PAHi3, which will be used predominantly for office productivity purposes. To do a quick test of the computing prowess of the NUC, I'll be running Cinebench R23 single-core and multi-core tests to see how this little PC is going to perform. As a side note, the approximate temperature of my surroundings is around 30 degrees Celsius, and the idle CPU package temperature for the NUC is around 35 degrees Celsius. With the R23 multicore test, we see that the NUC gets a score of 3,332 while maintaining an average CPU package temperature of 80 degrees Celsius. For the single core test, the NUC clocks in at 1,316 while maintaining an average CPU package temperature of 61 degrees Celsius. In conclusion, the NUC11PAHi3 seems to fit the bill for someone on the lookout for a PC with a small footprint that is more than capable of serving as an office productivity machine that can even get a spot of, say, photo and graphic editing out of the way. I got this NUC for $410 Singapore or around $303 US for you international folks during a recent e-commerce sale in Singapore in March of 2022. And for this price, I'd say that this represents pretty good value. With that, thank you so much for watching. Do like and subscribe if you've enjoyed this video, and I hope to catch you guys around the next time.